Last year was a really tough year for me. It was the year I became a germaphobe and started to go to work in my pajamas. But in all seriousness, I went through a lot of personal turmoil because of the COVID-19 pandemic. My entire lifestyle and routine had changed. I couldn't see my friends or family. I was scared for my health and those I cared about. This really shook me and made me think, if me as a generally healthy person is feeling this unstable, how is everyone else holding it together? How will this impact our community? And how can I, as a mental health designer, help? In early 2020, I was involved in a project at work that reframed the lens in which I looked at mental health design. It was a project that introduced me to frameworks, tools, case studies, and approaches in pursuit of designing spaces with a whole community approach. This is what I want to share with you today. Who am I? Well, my name is Anosha Zanjani. I'm a behavioral health design specialist at HDR with a former career in the field of mental health and clinical research. But I really see myself, most importantly, as an advocate of using the built environment to foster mental resiliency in our communities. Why is this so critical at this moment? Well, communities across the United States are facing severe hardships due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Community leaders are striving to learn how they can better prepare their community to handle future challenges of equal or greater magnitude, ultimately to build resilience. Resilience is the ability to recover from a disaster that could have been prevented or mitigated with sustainable practices. Sustainable practices contribute to resilience, and both are the ultimate goals of a healthy society. Alarmingly, this pandemic is occurring against a backdrop of increased prevalence of mental health issues that preceded the virus. With the additional rise in mental health issues due to COVID-19, it has resulted in a second curve that needs flattening, a global behavioral health crisis. This has brought community mental health to the forefront of the resiliency conversation. In response, HDR has expanded beyond sustainability to focus on regenerative design, which includes a spirit of recovery of the natural environment, community mental health, and wellness. Regenerative design speaks to the entire living system, which includes habitat, people, building, infrastructure, and their impacts on each other. This looks at mental health as an interrelated system embedded in a larger framework. To take a deeper dive into what constitutes regenerative design, we have formulated a set of performance indicators, looking at both ecological and social factors of sustainability. Mental health has been included as a key indicator for human health. However, we must note, at a community level, the driver to implement any sort of framework, including regenerative design, is reliant on our community mental health. If people are unable to get out of bed, they will not be productive members of society with a purpose to make any such changes. Therefore, to build a resilient society, one must look at mental health continuum of care infrastructure and work to build such services in society to support these larger systems which promote community mental health. To address this at a project scale, we at HDR have begun quantifying the regenerative design performance indicators through tools such as the Health and Wellness Tool and the Social Equity Toolkit. These tools allow us to design for community resiliency, resulting in projects that have a more whole community approach. The Health and Wellness Tool is a unique tool within the design industry that is evaluating health metrics in a three-dimensional environment and providing weighted scores for various design options. These metrics evaluate fundamental considerations related to designing for mental health, such as connection to nature, quality of light, beneficial acoustics, choice, among others. The tool also provides a financial impact assessment for various design elements as they relate to the health and well-being of the building occupant. This has revolutionized the way we as designers test design ideas. On the other hand, our recently developed Social Equity Toolkit pushes to cultivate a design process that encourages the development of fair, healthy, and supportive environments for disadvantaged communities. We have developed the Social Equity Toolkit to focus our attention on these civic issues. By working with community partners and stakeholders, we identify key challenges and strategies with an aim to design for community empowerment, mental health, as well as safety. With these considerations in mind, HDR's recently completed pre-design study, Behavioral Health Outpatient and Research Facility, embodies this well-rounded definition of regenerative design. The facility has taken a whole community approach, prioritizing healing, flexibility, and connectivity to the community. We also aimed to reach net zero energy, achieve carbon balance, and provide clean air for occupants, which is very important in behavioral health environments. This was accomplished through a once-through passive-capable distributed mechanical system using stack effect buoyancy and waste heat to drive air movement through the building. We also worked with our structural engineers to identify readily available opportunities to reduce embodied carbon in certain building material categories. This resulted in a 10-story, 110-square-foot mass timber tower with a 20-square-foot light shaft for light and natural ventilation. Design concept also supported key elements of a healing environment, such as a welcoming, deinstitutionalized, and normalized patient experience, spatial clarity, connection to nature and daylight, emphasis on safety, and a sense of community. An emphasis was also placed on the role the facility could play in the larger community to help meet the mental health demands and address continuum of care. This was done through a programmatic element of the facility, aiming to meet community mental health goals ranging from strengthening crisis intervention to supporting innovation to addressing the threat of suicide in the community. The building was also designed with some innate flexibility to accommodate for current, future, and unforeseen spatial needs. While each floor remains generally the same organizationally, the distribution of spaces to support various clinical needs can be modified on a floor-by-floor basis, making the building more adaptable as community mental health needs change. Ultimately, the team developed a design which could act as a model in service of this community holistically. And like many communities around the country, when behavioral health issues are left untreated, they can play a pivotal role in the growing and costly challenges, such as homelessness, violence, overdose, suicide, and the inability to remain engaged in schoolwork and family. A true challenge for resiliency. With our nation's mental health at risk due to recent events, at HDR, we are dedicated on working together to build more resilient communities that empower its residents. We do this through a design process that works with both our communities and our clients, uses sustainable frameworks, tools, and looks at each project as an opportunity to build a more resilient and sustainable future. I'm looking forward to your questions, and if you're interested in learning more, please feel free to reach out to me or Duncan Griffin, the managing principal of our Seattle studio.